Buddy Holly Records on his guitar. Geoff Barker loves his rock and roll, with stories from cramming a boathouse in Twickenham to watch the Stones to marching in demand of a dedicated rock and roll show on Radio 1. He's seen it all. He's done it all. And he's going to play us some tracks this evening. And Geoff, hiya. Am I right in saying that it was the Ace Cafe on London's North Circular Road that did it for you? Rock and roll comes on the jukebox and there's no turning back from there.
Goodness me, you've been reading up my history. Yeah, absolutely. It was. It was a famous biker's cafe on the North Circular Road. Oh, I didn't have a bike. I was too young. I was about 13. I went in there and heard a Brenda Lee record called Let's Jump the Broomstick on the jukebox. First time I ever heard that. And that's really where I guess it kicked all off, you know. Yeah. But yeah, I did all that and, you know, did the rock and roll march and all the rest of it and interviewed all sorts of people. I've been very fortunate to do that down through the years. And
only reading
here
up,
I am chatting to you, which is great.
Ever so slightly reading up, but because I grew up listening to you. You'll hate me for saying that. But here we are having a natter. Who did you interview? What stands out for you over the years?
I guess two big names. Sam Phillips may not be known to everybody, the man who ran Sun Records in Memphis, and he first recorded Johnny Cash, Jerry Lewis, Carl Perkins, Roy Orbison, and of course Elvis. But in terms of, you know, worldwide fame and importance and influence, I did a couple of programmes in the late 90s with Sir Paul McCartney, and that was pretty special. And Tom Jones and Jules Holland did a thing with them in 2004. That was another programme. So I've been very fortunate to meet a lot of my heroes and, you know, get involved in a lot of good music, really, you know.
Well, tonight you've got an awesome section for us, which you'll take away, and we're all set if you are.
Okay, right. Well, I think if anybody needed to define what rock and roll was, if an alien landed on Earth and someone said, what is rock and roll? This next record would be the one to play him or her everything that was wild and raucous about rock and roll. It's Little Richard, and it was recorded this very week in 1955. It gave him his first hit in America. And it starts with those immortal words. Well, look, I'll tell you what, let's Little Richard do it. Here's Little Richard.
Rock to the west, but she's the gal that I love best. To the booty, oh Rudy. 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 Wop, bop, loom, bop, lump, bump, bum. I got a gal named Daisy. She almost drives me crazy. Got a gal named Daisy. She almost drives me crazy. She knows me. Yes, indeed. Boy, you don't know what you do to me. To the booty, oh Rudy. 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 Bop, bop, bop. What you do to me, to the booty?
And that is rock and roll. The late Little Richard passed away just a few weeks back. the all-time classic, Tutti Frutti, recorded this week in New Orleans in 1955, where he made most of his records, all his classic stuff. He wrote that song, and it initially had rather risque, naughty lyrics, so the producer said, we can't possibly get this released. And they brought in a local woman who used to write songs for the label called Dorothy Labostri, and she wrote parts of the song. And the reason I mention her name, because if you have that on a vinyl 45 or a CD or anything, you will see her name, because she got a credit with it alongside Little Richard. And I'm sure she'll be extremely happy, because it sold a multi-million down through the years, and the number of people that have covered that as well. And let's hope the royalties poured in. Now, here's another guy to whom, well, what can you say? It's Elvis. His bass player, Bill Black, who started out with him at Sun Records, which we were just talking about, Oscar and I, in Memphis. And he was born this week in 1926, died in 64, much too young. He's pioneered the slap bass technique. He played an upright acoustic bass in the early days with Elvis, and they didn't have a drummer, so he used to slap it to give that a sort of a rhythmic sound, which was set the seal for all rockabilly bands to this very day. But Bill also later on played electric bass, but his upright slap bass is to the fore on this one. Recorded after Elvis had left Sun Records and went to RCA Records, where he became the world phenomenon that we knew. Recorded in 1956. It's such a great track. This is Elvis and My Baby Left Me. Ending with that familiar slap bass from the late Bill Black, born this week, 1926. Just magnificent. So much energy with Elvis and Scotty Moore's guitarist. This week in 1960, the Shadows emerged from the shadow of Cliff, we could say, because up prior to then, the Shadows and Cliff were a unit, and they went out touring with him. But this week in 1960, they branched out on their own and did their first UK tour without him. The first date was in Bristol. And they used to open their show with a sort of a little tease for the public. They'd start with the opening drum bits on their number one hit, Apache, which was boom, 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 boom. If you know it, you'll know what I'm talking about. If not, it's a mystery. And then they went into a famous Duane Eddy song called Shazam. Now, the only live version that I know about of them recording that wasn't the one they did in Bristol, but it was just a year later when they were on tour in South Africa. So I thought we'd just play that, because it must be exactly how they sounded back in those days. So on tour on their own in 1960, here's The Shadows live and Shazam.
Thank you.
Screaming went on. The Shadows live in 1961 with Shazam, how they started their tour, their set on their very first live tour, which kicked off this week in 1960 in Bristol. The great Hank Williams, without any question, the father of modern country music, was born this week in 1923. The amount of songs, his catalogue of songs, was just incredible. Recorded by hundreds of people, from Frank Sinatra to Ray Charles to every country artist you care to name. And I just thought I'd play a couple. One in a moment is a tribute, but let's play one of his most famous songs, which lots and lots of people recorded this. An incredible roster of songs. This is Fats Domino from 1961 and his version of Jambalaya.
Goodbye, Joe. Me gotta go, me oh my, me gotta go, pull the piro down Dubai. My Yvonne, sweetest one, me oh my, son of a gun, we'll have big fun on the bayou. Jambalaya, crawfish pie, really gumbo. Cause tonight I'm gonna see my machete mio. Pick it tall, feel through jaw, and be yell. Son of a gun, we'll have big fun on the bayou. To see it all by the dozen. Dressed in style, go hog wild and be yelled. Son of a gun, we'll have big fun on the bayou. Jambalaya, crawfish pie, really gumbo. Cause tonight I'm gonna see my machete meal. Pick your tall, feel through jaw, and be yell. Son of a gun, we'll have big fun on the bayou.
Wonderful track, the great Fats Domino singing Hank Williams' Jambalaya. And the people that have recorded Hank's songs down through the years, born this week in 1923. This isn't one of his songs, but it's about him. And it's a great Johnny Cash, another country music legend. And it's a song about the night he saw Hank Williams. And it's a great story. That's the title of the track. So here we go with Johnny Cash and The Night Hank Williams Came to Town.
Harry Truman was our president. A Coke and burger cost you 30 cents. I was still in love with Mavis Brown on the night Hank Williams came to town. I Love Lucy debuted on TV. That was one big event we didn't see, cause no one stayed at home for miles around. It was the night Hank Williams came to town. Mama ironed my shirt and Daddy let me take the truck. I drove on out to Grapevine and picked old Mavis up. We hit that county line for one quick round. On the night Hank Williams came to town, 1,000 people sweltered in the gym. Then I heard someone whisper, "Hey, that's him." That's when the crowd let out this deafening sound. It was the night Hank Williams came to town. On and on,
sang into the night. Jambalaya, cheating heart, I saw the light. And how'd they get Miss Hawdry in that gown?
On the night Hank Williams came to town. Mavis had her picture made with Hank out by his car. She said he sure is humble for a grand old opera star. Mavis said, why don't we hang around? It ain't often that Hank Williams comes to town. While Hank signed his autograph on Beulah Reisner's fan, Mavis got acquainted with the drifting cowboys band. The effect on all our lives was quite profound. On the night Hank Williams came to town.
Remember, friends and neighbors, Hank Williams and all the drifting cowboys will be at the high school gym in person for one show only this Saturday night. The big 2-hour show starts at 7:30. Tickets are just $1.50. You get your money's worth the first 15 minutes, and the rest is free.
Great. Tickets $1.50. You get your money's worth the first 15 minutes. The rest of the show is free. I must remember that. Johnny Cash and the night Hank Williams came to town. How it was. Remembering the legend of Hank Williams, born in 1923. Right, this next one is also linking ahead to something I'm going to be doing here on the show next week, on this little bit of the show next week. It's a track produced by the legendary Joe Meek, record producer from Gloucestershire, and he had a whole bunch of hits. The biggest one was an instrumental called Telstar, which topped the American charts and the British charts in 1962. But he also recorded an actor who was in The Great Escape, John Layton, with a track called Johnny Remember Me. The reason I'm mentioning this is when Joe Meek died, all his recording tapes were all locked away and subject to legal wrangling for years and years, and they sat in tea chests somewhere in London, and they'd achieved mythical status. People didn't believe they existed. Well, they have come to light. They've been purchased by a specialist record company, and a good friend of mine who will be known to you if you've been listening to the show for any length of time, a guy called Alan Wilson, who runs Western Star Records just outside of Bath, who's a massive Joe Meek fan and a great producer. He's been given the job of going through nearly 2,000 reels of Joe Meek recordings and archiving them so this record company can start releasing them. And there's rumours of all sorts of people who were later famous being on these reels of tape. So I'm going to have a chat with Alan about it next week. Well, I just thought it'd get us in the mood, play a classic Joe Meek production with all his signature sound on it. This is John Layton and Johnny Remember Me.
When the mists are rising and the rain is falling and the wind is blowing cold across the moor, I hear the voice of my darling, the girl I love and lost a year ago.
Johnny, remember me.
Well, it's hard to believe, I know, but I hear her singing in the sign of the wind blowing in the treetops way above me. Yes, I'll always remember till the day I die. I'll hear her cry, Johnny, remember me. Someday, I guess, I find myself another little girl to take the place of my true love. But as long as I live, I know I'll hear her
singing in the sight of the wind blowing in the treetops way above me. Yes, I'll always remember till the day I die. I'll hear the cry of Johnny, remember me.
Great record, huge hit in 1961. John Layton, Johnny Remember Me, and just a little bit of trivia. The great Chaz Hodges of Chaz and Dave was playing bass in the band that were backed on there, and he did lots of recording for Joe Meek, who produced it. And next week I'll be chatting to Alan Wilson, finding out all about the 2,000 reels of tape of the Joe Meek T-Chest tapes, which have finally come to light after a dispute or whatever it was over 40 years. So that'll be next week, have a chat with Alan. So anyway, Oscar, thank you very much. Enjoyed that tonight. And
thank you. So,
maybe
so
I'll catch
good.
Up with you again sometime.
Yeah, love that segment. And before you go, you still play the guitar then, do you, Geoff?
Oh, I do, absolutely. Yeah, I was playing it a little bit earlier on. Yeah. Yeah, always okay, busy
well,
with that.
Well, yeah, one day it won't be you playing the tunes, it'll be you literally playing the tunes, won't it? And we look forward to that moment, set up
right.
A studio or something where you are, and we'll do that. Hey, lovely to chat, and you're back with,
yeah,
with
you
us and with John Randall next week. That's Geoff Barker. Thank you for that and the rest.
BBC Radio Devon.
Geoff Barker's Rock and Roll Part 2, and there was a bit of a clue you gave us to the first song you're going to do in rock and roll right now, Geoff, wasn't there? One that's used in discos and weddings and parties all around the, well, all around Europe, probably all around the world, to be perfectly honest. That's right, isn't it?
Yeah, Raoul Marlow, the man in the band who did the song, which was Dance the Night Away, and the band were The Mavericks, that was the clue, he said it's possibly one of the most covered function band songs ever. If you go and see, somebody always does this song or that song, Dance the Night Away. That's not the one I'm playing, because I'm playing them doing a Hank Williams song. This week in 1923, Hank Williams, the father of modern country music, was born. And if there's somebody, anyone in country music who says they weren't influenced by Hank, then don't believe them. The man's catalogue was incredible. The songs that he wrote, which have been recorded by everybody from Frank Sinatra to Ray Charles to Fats Domino, who did a great version of Jambalaya, one of his many songs. But anyway, here's the Mavericks from their, I think, their first major album. They got their first major record deal in Nashville in 1992. So it's before Dance the Night Away, which was a hit in 98. Here they are with the Hank Williams song, Hey Good Looking.
Hey, hey. said, good luck. Well, how's the back again? Something's up with me.
Well, Marlowe fronting the Mavericks in a great version of the Hank Williams song, Hey Good Looking, giving it one of those classic Elvis endings. Recorded in 1992, as I said, when they've got their first major record deal, a Hank Williams song, the great Hank Williams. And let's go into another one. Someone who was a massive fan of Hank and recorded loads and loads of his songs was Jerry Lee Lewis. And they came from sort of similar backgrounds, country boys, that part of the world in the South, in the USA. And he just loved Hank Williams and took Hank's songs and made them his own. Here's one that he recorded when he was at Sun Records, the legendary Sun Records, in 1957. Jerry Lee Lewis with a Hank Williams song, You Win Again.
The news is out all over town. Where you been seen? Out running round. I know that I should leave. What can I do? You win again. Well, this heart of mine could never see what everybody knows but me. Just trusting you was my great sin. What can I do? All soon like mine, his head shall bow. He'll give his heart, but all in vain. And someday say, you win again. Well, this heart of mine could never see what everybody knows but me. Just trusting. What can I do? You win again.
And as the great Waylon Jennings wrote in a song about Hank Williams, I don't think Hank did it that way. And he certainly didn't do it that way. And I wonder what he would have thought of that. Jerry Lee Lewis with the Hank Williams song, You Win Again. He recorded two versions of that, Jerry Lee, a slow version, but I thought I'd just play that one. Remembering the great Hank Williams, born in 1923. And if you just want a little bit of interest in his songs, just go and have a look online and put in Hank Williams songs. The list is just immense and amazing. Oh, he wrote that, he wrote that, he wrote that.